biggest prize in the game. Stuart Bingham has been in fine form this season. He won the English Open. He was runner-up recently, of course, at the Welsh Open.
Sean Murphy wins the leg.
Sean Murphy, on the other hand, has had a bit of a mare. Six first-round exits in ranking events this season, and before yesterday's win over Mark King, he'd lost six, make it five out of six matches he played. So his form has fallen off a cliff by his own admission. Of course, we had him in the commentary box yesterday, and he's looking to turn his season around as quickly as possible. And with this being a ranking event, well, it's a good place to start. Stuart Bingham is a former runner-up here. The man who denied him the title, Dominic Dale, is alongside us in the commentary box. Good evening,
Stuart Bingham,
Dominic.
Good evening, Phil. Good evening, everybody, and welcome to...
Start o'clock, please.
...the recommencement of the madness.
And what a start. A snooker off the break and ball in hand with Murphy failing to hit a red. So this is an early opportunity in how Bingham would love to make something big here.
One.
And close it out at the first attempt.
Yes, I can't blame Sean Murphy for trying that glancing two cushion escape. It's imperative you don't give your opponents an opportunity. Unfortunately, he just failed to come in the reds, and as you can see, Stuart Bingham's got an opportunity here, but is he on his intended
Eight.
Red here?
Bingham was in sparkling form in his first round match, thrashed Matthew Stevens, who didn't trouble the scorers, and at the end he was playing
Nine.
To the crowd with some brilliant positional shots on the yellow, with the frame already won. They do love a yellow here in Watford. But he has been in really good nick
16.
In very recent times. Looking to continue that and go one step further than he did 5 years ago against you.
Sean Murphy, I'm worried that he may not get back to the table here. Stuart's developed the reds very nicely, and he's a great builder. Just lost out in the Welsh Open to Neil Robertson. Well, about a week ago now, wasn't it? 9 frames to 7.
22.
But as you say, Phil, Sean Murphy can't buy a match at the moment. Lost 6-3 to qualify for China to Adam Stefanov, little-known player.
Well, where did that come from? That is a real surprise from Bingham, who's just
22.
Told Rachel that you can miss anything in the cauldron, the pressure cooker of the shootout. And there is proof. So Murphy gets the chance I'm sure he wasn't expecting. Here's the red. I mean, he'd miss one of those in 50, wouldn't he, if that?
Yeah, you're absolutely right, Phil. I mean, this tournament really does find you out. It's so hard to cue properly and deliver the cue. There's so much pressure. It just
Six.
Makes you so tight, and you know, it's just hard to cue smoothly. Ooh, Sean on the black here.
Seven.
Looks as though he's okay. Murphy's a semi-finalist here at the shootout. In fact, the first year it was a ranking event.
14.
He got to the last four. Made the quarter-finals a couple of years prior to that. So he's got some
50.
Form when it comes to the shootout, even though this season's form has been forgettable. Of course, the one exception was his run to the final in Glasgow at the Scottish Open, where he looked as though he was getting back to something like his best, missing out in the title match to his good friend Mark Allen.
22.
I'll tell you what, Phil, has been terrifically unfortunate there. Ploughed through the reds, played a good shot. He's got a tough red to the right centre here, which he's missed. Reprieve for Stuart Bingham.
Sean Murphy, 22.
So just 4 points between them. Not an easy red, but he missed it by quite a margin. And this is tougher than the one Bingham just missed, for sure. But this time, no mistake, right in the middle.
One.
So the 2015 world champ, who of course beat Murphy in the final, in one of the best ever finals for the sheer quality of the snooker. Back in and in front.
Six.
I'm sure when Stuart was taking that red on into the left centre, he'd been mindful of the easy one that he'd missed, and well, he won't want to make a mistake now, second time round.
Seven.
Just needs one good positional shot here. As you can see, the sort of the pink and the four reds are sort of all in one another's way. Oh, he's played this pretty well. It's about the best he could do. It's a thin cut, this red, but it's on.
12.
He controlled that well, didn't he? There was always the danger of overcooking.
17.
There's still plenty there, and there's still more than half the match to go. Fantastic atmosphere again inside the Coliseum. Quite an intimidating atmosphere.
John Murphy, Stuart Bingham, 17.
A player who handles it best is going to come through tomorrow night.
Down to just 10 seconds per shot now. Less than 5 minutes to go. Sean Murphy, 21 points ahead. Will need an opportunity fairly quickly, you'd think.
Oh, what a pot. He used up his full allocation there, Bingham, and it was worth the wait.
And I'll tell you what, I'll be rolling the cue ball in behind the green here. This is what he's going to do.
Just effective. Bingham doesn't care about that. It was the perfect visit, wasn't it? Great long red. Murphy back in trouble. Hit and hope, that's all he could do. And he's left an easy one.
Yeah, I think Sean was giving himself the best chance there to possibly fluke something to give himself an opportunity. But yes, as you can see, it's ought to be match over now.
One.
Lead is 23. Still plenty of time for Murphy, but he's running out of reds. Being a strong favourite now then.
Seven.
To finish the job.
Eight.
I was to, I wouldn't be cannoning the red off the cushion here. Just pop the pink, take the 6 points, and that's what he's done.
Fourteen.
Once again, staying cool, using virtually
15.
His entire 10 seconds to make sure that red disappeared. This is frame ball, but he doesn't worry about that. The safety shot's just as good in this situation. Both reds awkward for Murphy.
15.
And that pretty much sums up the magician's season, really.
Stuart Bingham, 6.
Starting with a snooker off the break from Stuart Bingham, and then ball in hand. Here's another one to finish the job.
Shame for Sean Murphy, really. This is a type of event that just could have kick-started his season. It's a sort of event that so many players are capable of winning. But as you say, Phil, it's not going to be Sean Murphy's yet.
No, but Stuart Bingham is looking strong, isn't he? He's got the necessary nous, and he's got the scoring power when he gets in to do the damage. It's a pretty impressive combination, that, when it comes to the shootout. There's the handshake. Sean Murphy offering his hands.